And greetings all, and welcome to Wisdom Speak. This is your host, Woman is Life, and Sister Mu is on her way. If you give me a few minutes, we're going to get the show started. Give me 1 minute intermission, and I'll be right back to start the show, okay?
Blame on now I can know your father. You say they came and they took all we had possessed. They had to take the abuse and they have caused the present state within hidden history. Use our goodness and nourishment in the name of missionary.
Thank you all for patiently waiting. This show today on Wisdom Speak will be about the two-family income. Is it a myth or a reality? That is the question we will discuss today. So just brief, this discussion came up basically because we're trying to figure out, you know, how people are struggling. We have two incomes in a family. Everyone's working. Everyone's hustling and still not meeting. So we decided to go ahead and figure out, is this a myth? Is it something that is possible? Or is it truly reality where you can make it work with the income you have, be it one or the two incomes that, you know, they say we need to survive? So thank you all for joining and listening. Let's start with the main big thing. The first thing is you and your mate, y'all both working, y'all both in that struggle, you're on that grind daily. You both have income coming in, be it salary, hourly, or, you know, you got your business is rolling and both of you are working. And it seems like your bills aren't still meeting. You still have that shortfall somewhere. So I'm going to pause and I'm going to bring Sister Mu on the line.
What's happening?
What's up, Sister Mu? All right, I'm just starting the show. Just starting the show. We're going to talk about that myth of reality with those two family incomes. So what you want to bring, or you want to go ahead and get your greetings?
Well, most definitely, peace and blessings to everybody listening now and everybody who will be listening later. But today's topic is fire to me. I mean, so many people going through this, dealing with it, you know, trying to figure out, is it myth, is it reality, is it fact, is it fiction, you know, or basically, is it a two-edged sword, you know? And I've been out talking to people, I've been talking to the brothers and to the sisters and trying to find out how they feel about it. You know, I'm hoping that we can just, like, open some minds today and get people on that vibe, like, start questioning shit, like, why is it like this? And I know you got a lot of input, sister, because you just ride or die with it, and you doing it, and you holding it down. So I think it's time for us to really to really just bust this whole subject wide open and get folks thinking about it. Is it a myth or is it reality?
Okay. So, you know.
Now, definitely want to let people know that they can call in. They can call in and share their insights and what they feel about this topic. So, two family incomes, myth or reality. The number is 646-378-1321. If anybody wants to join in and just give their insight, you know, anytime, feel free.
Okay. You know, I've done it both ways. I've done it where I've had a mate and we didn't have any, you know, children, and we had the two incomes, and it seems like we still struggled. I've done it where it's just been me, and I've still struggled, or, you know, sometimes I can make it work. And so, you know, you got to find that balance. So what we're told is if it's two of y'all, you both work, you should have no problems. All your bills should be taken care of. You should have money put up, saved. You should have food on your table, gas in your car. Your transportation should be taken care of. So why doesn't it work? So
I think a lot of brothers and sisters are not questioning this. They're not questioning it, and it's so serious. But it's like, to me, the first things I wonder is like, okay, many families ask this question, you know, like, I want to live the American dream. I want to be upper middle class. I want to be, you know, somewhere in the fold, and I want to have this financial security. It's what I hear a lot of brothers and sisters talk about. You know, if I'm on the grind and I'm working and my queen is working, then you know, all this should come together. But you know what I found is, you know, and what a lot of brothers and sisters have found as well, is that we're going through this thing and we're trying to make it work, whether we're married, you know, or if we're just together and we're trying to pull this whole two income thing, but we're running into a lot of obstacles. You know, and this particular topic is very near and dear to my heart because, you know, I'm a happily married Black woman, you know, and a mother. My king and I sat down and we decided that he would stay home. Ooh, you know, a lot of people look at you kind of sideways when you say that. But
they question that masculinity. Why he at home?
Why he at home?
Why he taking care of the kids?
Right. But
why can't
you know
he
what?
Work?
We,
what's the problem? He's supposed to be taking
exactly.
care of you and family.
He's supposed to be the provider, right? But when we sat down and we thought about making this choice, you know what I'm saying? The things that we really had to look at, the things that were really important to us were the affordability and the resources in our particular area. And unfortunately, or fortunately, we found that we could do well. On one income,
you still there?
Yeah, I'm here. I'm just wondering what's going on. See, we got these technical difficulties. I think some energy is getting released when we start talking.
All right,
when we start talking about some things. But what we had to do was sit down and take a look at our affordability, what our resources were in our area, you know, and basically it was a no-brainer who would stay home and who wouldn't for this point in time because, you know, I don't know if anybody else, you know, has the same feeling. A lot of times my king would be able, he works in, you know, restaurant industry. And when the economy is good, people go out to eat. And when the economy is bad, people don't. So we made that decision based on who at the time was in a more stable, you know, I guess, working situation. I worked in the medical field, so I opted to stay at work, to go into work or whatever, and